Hi, I'm Peter Andre, and I am here to help.
Peter Andre is ready to give something back.
I've always said that I really appreciate the support the great British public have given me.
Pete and his team are travelling up and down the country offering a helping hand to the nation.
People of Harrow, we need your help.
Please come and help our lifeboat station. Yeah,
Peter, I really desperately need your help.
Pete has only 4 days to try and make a difference to people's lives, with Team Andre by his side.
Team Andre is in the building.
Brother Mike, road manager Carl, manager Nicola, and this week, a helping hand from BG, Robin Gibb.
Peter!
The Here to Help mission means that Pete has a few rules. No money can change hands.
Yes.
Using his celebrity status as a bargaining tool, he'll pull favours from the community in exchange for his time.
You have to give us something for free, but in exchange, I'll do something for you. I'm at your disposal. I'm ready to negotiate.
You tell me what you want me to do.
Calm down. You need our help with something you're doing.
That deserves a hug.
Come here.
And to get the job done, Pete must roll up his sleeves and get stuck in.
That's for a tenner. Come on, let's go.
I'm getting the hang of it now.
Whatever the challenge, Pete and his team are here to help. This week, Pete's in the quaint town of Thame in Oxfordshire, home of the Thame Carnival. For years, the event was a great success. Thousands of people attended, the floats were spectacular, and the carnival raised thousands of pounds for local charities. But by last year, it was on its last legs, a miserable turnout of just 800 people. Two modest floats and a drastic slump in funds raised for charity. Pete's received a call for help to revamp the carnival. Local hairdressers Mark and Jade have written to Pete to ask if he can transform Thame's tiny lackluster carnival into a heart-stopping extravaganza.
There's not a lot going on in Thame. With the carnival itself, it's one way of the whole community get back together, and also I think it's my time to actually give back to the community that I live in, hence why I'm doing it with the charity in mind and for future generations.
Hi Peter, my name's Jade. I would really like you to come to the carnival this year to spice it up a little bit, basically.
They want to draw a bigger crowd, raise a larger slice of money for charity and restore the carnival to its former glory. Mark's big idea is to bring a touch of Rio to Thame.
What I want to see is the whole place alive with music, colour, floats. I want it to be like Notting Hill Carnival. I want it to be like bloody Rio de Janeiro.
We want to walk through the streets of Thame, dressed in these costumes, with feathers in our hair, our asses hanging out.
But he and Jade are going to need Pete's help big time.
I live around here, but I never knew there was a carnival, so I've never been to it.
I didn't really know they had a carnival. Seems a bit dodgy, a bit grotty.
Peter, I need you to come and help me raise the profile of the carnival. I need you to help me get people to the event. Line the streets. I want you to help me get more floats coming down the street. I want you to help me get raffle prizes and get money for our charities. I want you to help me get the community spirit back together. So come along, help me make Thame Carnival the biggest fun day out we've ever had.
It's day one and Pete's getting his first glimpse of the challenge he faces this week.
Last year we had two floats. This year we won 100 floats.
What, 100?
Do you think I'm mad?
Yes, oh, I love it.
Last year the parade didn't have the sort of wow factor that it had back in the day.
Will Barrett. I'm sorry, I should have laughed, but that's so sweet. Love it. I've got ideas straight away. I think, you know, where this is different is this is not about a family, this is not about an individual, this is about a whole community.
It's Wednesday and Mark and Jade are at the town hall in a meeting.
I think you could get some street entertainers as well. I think we need. Yeah. I think working in pairs might work quite well.
Yeah.
They volunteered themselves onto the carnival committee to help get the show buzzing again. But carnival's on Saturday, which leaves only 3 days to turn it around. Pete's planning to hijack the meeting, which the members believe is being filmed for the council's website.
There's a committee meeting going on up here. We're going to go up there and we're going to find out now. So let's go have a look.
We need to get some more things going now with this carnival. So I suggest we start organising a few more jobs.
I'm sorry to interrupt your meeting, but then again, I'm not, because this is going to be amazing.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Mark, how are you? Nice to see you.
Pete gets straight down to business and is full of ideas.
What do you want to achieve?
Do you want to try and create this carnival to be the best we've ever had? And so for next year, people then get involved and say, yeah, that's amazing, I want to get involved next year.
You've got a problem there. You've called it Tame Carnival. You're not even saying it's an exciting carnival. I know it's called Tame. Why don't we turn the name from Tame Carnival to Street Party? We need the masks. We need the makeup. We need the dancers. I think we should get Brazilian dancers down here. I think we should get people playing bongos, percussion in the street. And I'm willing to do whatever it takes to make this happen on the weekend.
He came in and within 2 seconds he had so many ideas of what he wanted to do by getting people involved and getting all the community involved too.
You want 100 floats?
Yep.
We might be able to get 10, I was going to say. But let's get 20, yeah. But
so Pete set himself a target of 20 floats, 10 times more than last year's disappointing turnout.
I think we can do this. I do. I've got to go.
Yep.
Thank you very much, everybody.
I think it's amazing that he's here to help us. I just think he will make the whole thing vast.
Committee members Nicola and Jane are excited by Pete's new take on their carnival.
I just feel really fizzy because I'm like, it's just want to get stuff done.
He's given us a real big buzz today that it's going to just hit the stratosphere.
Let the day begin. G'day.
Pete's presence is already whipping up a storm in town.
Right, Saturday, we're going to have a street party right here. Are you all coming on Saturday?
But if he's going to pull off a street party to remember, he'll need major help from Team Andre. He's summoned them to the field where the carnival's fate takes place.
Now, we're going to put on a carnival this weekend. Don't freak out. I'm telling you, I'm on it. The procession's going to go all the way up the high street, and it's going to all end up in here. And then we need to fill this field with people, bands, we need stores, we need
everything we can get around.
No.
So you're telling me we've got 4 days?
2.5, because the third day is the Mardi Gras.
Pete's already hit on the idea of a Team Andre float to help draw the crowds.
We need to get a truck for us, a big float. We need to speak to them about all other floats.
You want a float of your own?
Yeah.
On there?
Our team's float.
So what are we going to do? Do we have an idea of what you want on the float?
I have no idea.
No, I'm just trying to get my head around how
two and a half days
to put a Mardi Gras together.
This guy's stuck on 2.5 days.
So I haven't really stressed out about anything yet, but this one's going to be difficult.
Despite the team's fears, it's back to business and Pete returns to town. The Carnival Committee have already been working hard to spread the word, but Pete's arrival has inspired them to give their campaign one final celebrity push.
Sorry to barge in on you, but please put this in your window.
As soon as the news spread, we were looking out the window and there was kids running around everywhere.
Would you put that in your window, please?
We would indeed.
Thank you very, very much.
Now he's outside and it's mayhem, so it's going to be good.
My God, this smells good, Mick. Can you put this in your window? It's just to advertise the carnival. Thank you, my friend. Thank you. Every shop's important. This is buzzing. We want this street buzzing. You gorgeous, you are. Hiya. That was absolute madness. But we're handing them out. I mean, this is great. We are handing them out. We've definitely untamed Tame.
Coming up, Pete's crying out for the word to be spread. Mike's already feeling the strain.
It's going to be really difficult to get everything in place in a short period of time.
And the brothers get into the party spirit. Andre's in the historic town of Tame in Oxfordshire. He's here to help hairdressers Mark and Jay transform their town's tiny carnival from last year's two-float washout into the biggest Mardi Gras street party the town has ever seen.
I want it to be like Nottingham Carnival. I want it to be like bloody Rio de Janeiro.
Mark, Jade and the committee have already been working hard to reinvent the carnival. But they want Pete's help and a bit of celebrity muscle to get the town behind them.
We need the masks, we need the makeup. I think we should get Brazilian dancers down here. I think we should get people playing bongos.
Pete's already hit the streets to put the word out.
Right, are you all coming on Saturday? Yeah!
Now he's got just 2.5 days left to get the party started.
I haven't really stressed out about anything yet, but this one's going to be difficult.
One of the most important things the carnival does is raise money for charities. To find out where the money goes, Pete's visiting one of the local charities who benefit. Tomley Hall is an activity centre where disabled children of all ages can come and have fun.
Let's go, ready? Don't beat me, though. Don't beat me. Just follow me.
The centre is used by over 5,000 children and their families every year. But facilities like this are expensive, which is why the carnival support is so vital.
Hamza, where are you? You coming?
Behind you.
This is an amazing, amazing thing you've got going on.
We've been really lucky, actually. Tame has really embraced us as the local charity. And the carnival has supported us for a number of years now. It's about supporting children, disabled children, and that's children with any kind of disability, but together with their brothers and sisters so they can all come together.
Oh, what? This is awesome.
Visit over, and the good the carnival does is crystal clear.
Obviously, the whole importance about the carnival now is the main reason, you know, is to raise money for the charities. In order for the charities to continue, it's really important. I think it all goes hand in hand. This will be, if we raise money, it means we've raised awareness. If we raise awareness, hopefully it leads to raising money. So it's important for us to put this on and put it on right.
Back in the town centre, Nicola and Mike are about to attend another committee meeting. But the scale of the project ahead is starting to worry them.
They have gone for a Mardi Gras theme. And so far, this, you know, we're only 2.5 to 3 days away from the festival, and there's nothing Mardi Gras about the high street whatsoever. It's going to be a huge task. It's going to be really difficult to get everything in place in a short period of time. If anything, this is probably one of the most difficult ones that I can see from now, just knowing what's involved in even putting together a float, let alone helping put together the whole event.
At this point in time, how many motorised floats have you got?
We've got six.
Six motorised? I would love just some of those guys with, you know, with just the drum around them and they're just playing that, and then two people beside them just blowing whistles. That's all. It's so simple but so effective.
Normally we kind of just work as ourselves, as Team Andre, but there is so much that I think we've got to have you guys, you know, your local knowledge and your contacts. And I think it will be phone calls and maybe between ourselves a lot of doorstepping.
Pete's backing for this year's carnival is already galvanising the whole community.
When I've walked around the town today, what I've realised is the positiveness of the shopkeepers about Tame Carnival this year. They're so buzzing, they can't wait for it to happen. They all think it's been amazing. And they want to go through and tell the story of why I want to do it and why we're trying to set it up.
To get his street party rally cry heard even more clearly, Pete's decided on a rather old-fashioned approach.
G'day, sir.
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
And you have to remember, when you're a town crier, you don't do it from the throat, you do it from here. You're a singer, you should know this.
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
But halfway through the lesson, there's a slight distraction.
What's going on out there?
I think it might be that they're asking for some sort of celebrity. Now, it's either you or it's me. I'm not sure which one.
Pete heads outside, as he's not one to miss any opportunity to publicise the carnival.
Oh, yay! Oh, yay! Oh, yay!
of June 2011. We are going to hold a carnival right here on the street, and we want you all there. Are you going to be there?
It seems the town is finally getting the message.
They must think someone else is in town because this is incredible. Oh my God.
While Pete is doing his best to spread the word, brother Mike is also trawling the streets to drum up support.
Festival
tame is not going to be so tame. It's going to be wild.
There you go, darling. There you go. Just take that. It's the tame festival.
But you'll go with my grandma and granddad.
Brilliant. Say, see you there. Right, bye.
Thank you.
See ya. Hello, mate.
On his rounds, Mike bumps into Mark, who's got great news. Since Pete hit town, the carnival schedule is really looking up.
How are we doing?
Oh, it's fantastic. Chaos. It's absolute chaos.
Anything progressed since yesterday, since last
year? Yeah, we've got a soul dancing group. We've had about three more parade entrants.
Fantastic.
Loads of more people can get on the stalls, but we've got no more room.
Well, isn't that brilliant? That's brilliant.
I've had loads of offers of help. Any surprises I need to know about?
No, you don't. You're on a need to know basis and you don't need to know right now.
All right, cheers, mate.
Have a good rest of the day.
I'll let you get on with it.
We're on it.
Now that the street party word is out, Pete turns his attention to the procession. To get maximum publicity and pull in the punters, Pete's decided Team Andre should have their very own float.
I've got a bit of a situation here because basically I've agreed to do a float, me and the team. Problem is, we haven't got a truck to put the float on. So probably the most important mission right now is to get this truck, because if I don't have the truck, I've got nowhere to put the float. The float won't float because it's not sitting on anything, so it will be grounded. I need this desperately. Now, we found a place that's not far from here. We're going to go there and ask, is it easy to blag a huge truck? No.
Hello, I'm here to see Kevin, if that's okay. Kevin, truck Kevin.
Okay.
Thank you. Truck Kevin.
Pete's tracked down a local haulage company. He needs to strike a deal for something that will help his float stand out.
My name's Peter.
Hi.
Is Kevin here?
Hi, Kevin.
I'm doing reception for you. So sweet. Kevin. Hi, mate, I'm Peter.
You surprised the life out of me.
Well, I've signed up to the carnival committee.
Yep.
Now, what our mission is on Saturday to make this carnival rock. So I do need your help. I need to put my float on one of your trucks, but I'm not allowed to pay for it. I can't get it for free. What I have to do is I have to trade with you. If you're going to accept that, you have to think of something that I have to do in order to get it, because I'm not allowed to get it for free.
You can walk around there, walk into that office, and give each one of the girls in that office a big kiss and a cuddle, and I'll take that.
Mate, I'm going to give you a hug for that. I should actually spray a bit of aftershave before I do this.
Deal sealed with a kiss. In exchange for showing the girls in the office some serious lip action, Pete's blagged a truck for the Team Andre float.
You were still okay with kissing me.
Kissing duty's over, it's time for another introduction, and this one's a biggie.
Now, what's my gosh.
Hello? I'm a truck.
That is mammoth. Oh my gosh.
There'd be no truck drivers if it wasn't for a truck.
And that's not just any old truck. That's a 12-wheeled, 44-ton Arctic lorry. Look what a few Peter Andre smackers can get you.
You are an absolute champion. This rocks. We can feel this, you know. Live band, dancers, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
It's local, it's supporting the local community, and he's doing something good for the local community. And the carnival needs to come back. I remember it as a kid. And it's not something you see very often now, so good luck to him.
So Pete's got the truck, now he just needs to fill it. He's got wind of a local samba dance troupe in nearby Oxford, and he's on his way to try and blag their services.
Hi, everyone. How are you? Hola, hola, hola. You know the place Tame?
Yeah.
Right? They have a carnival once a year. What are the chances that I can have you on Saturday for 1 hour, just, or even half an hour, just to precede this carnival?
Yeah, we can do so,
But since this is Here to Help, Pete can't pay the group to perform, so he'll need to strike a deal.
We want you to play the drum with us.
Yes. Can I do one now?
Well, yeah. I just introduced you to Beth, and our leader, and she's going to teach you what to do.
What about my brother? Can he join in?
He can join in as well. Yeah, of course.
Deal done. Pete's got the troupe to agree to appear on the Team André float. All he's got to do in exchange is to play drums for the rest of their rehearsal.
We were having a rehearsal and Peter André burst into the room. That was rather unexpected, to say the least. And not an unpleasant surprise. He asked us to kind of just bring our energy and our spirit to the carnival and kind of liven it up a little bit. How could we turn down an offer like that?
Oh my God, I want to be going up the street doing that. Just stretch in, get in the arms. That was Mick, have a go at that.
But Pete's natural rhythm gets the better of him and he can't help adding a little more to the mix.
Just showed him some basic steps. The maracatu we do is quite feminine, so it's very sensual. So I tried to do some steps that we could do together, and he picked it up. Yeah, it was quite good.
He can move, can't he? He's a musician. Good to hear him so fired up about carnival and what we do. And just really looking forward to bringing that to Tame now.
You lot are unbelievable, and thank you so much for agreeing to do this. You're going to make Tame very happy.
Outside, the André brothers seem to be lost in that catchy Brazilian rhythm. Coming up, it's back to the 60s for Team André.
That is just shagadelic, baby, yeah.
Pete asks for help from local celebrity Robin Gibb.
Hello.
And as the big day approaches, nerves start to set in about the Team André float.
The floor needs to be dressed in something, but it's 44 foot long, we need to fill it.
Yeah, we will.
Oh, I don't know, mate. It's massive, dude.
André is here to help in Tame, Oxfordshire. Hairdressers Mark and Jade have asked Pete to help transform their small-town carnival into a heart-stopping Brazilian Mardi Gras.
I think we can do this.
They need Pete's help in revamping the event's image and getting more people to attend and get involved, as well as help raising more money for charity. So far, Pete's done his best to repackage the carnival into an unmissable street party.
Are you all coming on Saturday?
He's managed to blag a truck so that Team André can have their own float. But with one day left, there is still a huge amount of work to do.
I think it'll be phone calls and maybe between ourselves a lot of doorstepping.
Pete wants one final push to get as many locals as possible behind the carnival. And he thinks the committee may have missed an obvious publicity stunt.
I want to know, actually, if they've ever had a banner.
So Team André have organised a huge banner for the high streets to shout the carnival message from the rooftops.
Hopefully this will be like a big step forward in creating, you know, in them feeling the buzz.
And it looks like it's Carl who's got the honour of putting it up.
Should we get it up there? Yeah. All right, let's get it up there so we can see it for the first time. We're going to reveal the banner of Tame.
Hey,
Good old Carl. I have to say, good on him for getting up there.
Carl, how you feeling?
It's not too bad, actually.
We've never had anything like this before, ever.
Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Well, jump up and down then.
I can't.
He's getting so wet up there, bless him.
That's amazing.
Yeah, really, really good.
We're making history. It's the first banner they've ever had in Thames.
Nice, bright, eye-catching. I'm really pleased with it.
Now the banner is up, Pete's got another idea. He's been told that the nearby Lord William School has over 3,000 pupils, so he's hoping a personal invitation will inspire them to turn up and cheer the carnival on.
Okay, guys, Tame have a carnival every year, and I want to see every single one of you there tomorrow, please, and bring your families. I want to let you know that you're the new generation, which means it's your party, and I want this every year because you guys can make it happen. So, question is, are you coming tomorrow?
Yeah!
I can't wait to see you tomorrow, and I want you guys to just enjoy every minute. Okay, this carnival is about you. You're wonderful. Thank you very, very, very much.
Mate, absolutely brilliant. You know, what a great school and great kids, and oh, I can't wait till tomorrow now.
Just in case all those kids do turn up, they need to be properly entertained. Pete's got an idea to bling up the Team Andre float, so heads out with Carl and Mike to the local fancy dress shop. But as this is here to help, first they'll have to do a deal with the shop owner if they want to get the outfits for free.
Hello.
My name is Peter.
As if we didn't know.
Say it.
Hello. This is Cherry. Hello.
Lovely.
Introductions over. Let's see if Pete can still cut a deal.
We want to bring the Tame Carnival back, and we need your help because we have to look the part. I have to ask you if you can give us some things or loan us, because we're not allowed to pay for it. But at the same time, you're not allowed to just give it to us. So if you do agree, I have to trade. So first of all, is there something you think you could loan us for the day?
Yeah.
What would you like us to do in order to get this?
We need somebody to do some hoovering.
Okay.
We've got a little bit of ironing to do.
She's got it.
Okay. Cherry and I would quite like a cup of tea.
I'm in.
Yeah?
I'm in.
Yeah, deal.
Let's go.
Done.
Deal.
Done. Right.
Deal done. For a spot of hoovering, ironing and a cup of tea, the shop owner lets the boys run wild in her shop.
We want to think carnival, you know.
Do you have afro wigs?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Can we try on some wigs?
Yeah.
Since this year's carnival theme is Mardi Gras, the boys have an excuse to go a bit exotic.
A, B, C, it's easy as 1, 2, 3.
Jackson 5, not very carnival. Boys, you need to try again.
1, 2, 3, baby, you and me, girl. But I've got to get serious now because we've got a carnival to put on.
Just at the back behind your ears, and then that sits there.
Hey, Mike, brilliant, brilliant.
Yeah, work it, we need some beads in there. Accessories, got to think accessories. Got to think accessories.
They're getting so carried away, they seem to have forgotten all about Mardi Gras.
What do you think of this kind of thing, you know, kind of...
That's what you wore on tour. I like it,
but
it's still you.
Should I trust anything that you say?
Yeah, man.
Very Prince Charming, Pete, but not very carnival.
It's got to catch people's attention, hasn't it?
Take two. Let's try again, guys.
What's he wearing?
What are we doing, guys?
Pretty woman walking down the street. Pretty woman, kind of like.
Oh my gosh, I've got to wear high heels.
I mean, we've got them for women.
Well, they're female boots, man, but I'm in. I've got an idea.
Mike, that is brilliant.
It's just shagadelic, baby, yeah. Actually, I've decided to change my mind.
Finally, there's a winner. Nicola's been spending the afternoon persuading local businesses to put on their own floats. And she can hardly believe her eyes.
Oh my God.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, baby.
I love it.
Nicola might be laughing, but she can't escape the fact that she needs to dress up too.
See, liking the outfit, it's the breasts.
Let go.
With costumes chosen, it's time for the work to begin. A few domestic chores, in character of course, are a small price to pay. With the hard graft over, it's time to go. But Mike and Carl have opted for an alternative way home.
Where are the boys? What? Are you serious?
She looks quite scared.
While the boys horse around, Mark and Jade are on the case trying to find donations for the raffle. It's a crucial part of Carnival since it's the raffle that raises most of the funds for local charities.
See you later. Bye-bye.
I'll give you a pack of golf balls as well.
Thank you very much. Okay. I really appreciate that about that.
Team Andre returned to the town centre to help them out.
If you do have anything for the raffle, be it box of wine or a hamper or anything you could do towards the raffle would be amazing.
In terms of the raffle, I'll donate you a case of wine.
Oh, superb. I hope everyone's like you.
Yeah, that was easy.
Nicola's got wind of a local bike shop willing to donate a major prize. But to secure it, they want some peat time. And it seems that the entire population of Tame wants to come along too.
Hello there. Wow.
But what I did think was it's only fair, as it is such a superb prize, that I did trade you off for just a few minutes.
Yeah, okay. What do you recommend?
Change of bike cable.
Deal done, and that was easy. In exchange for a brand new bike for the raffle, Pete's got to change a brake cable. Despite the ruckus outside, Pete is fully focused on his brake cable.
That was brilliant fun, brilliant. Oh, well, thank you, but look.
And a brake.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
Excellent.
No, thank you.
Thanks for letting me in your workshop. I've loved it. I'm just so glad that, you know, you could have easily just taken me for a ride.
With the deal in the bag, Pete's on a roll, and he's got one more raffle prize to pick up, having received a call from a local A-lister.
I've had the chance of getting a phone call from Mr. Robin Gibb, who's, you know, one of the Bee Gees, the biggest selling group of all time.
BG Robin Gibb has heard about Pete being in town to bling up the carnival and has left a message to say he will donate a raffle prize.
Robin! Hello.
How are you going? Good to see you.
Before they get down to business, Robin gives him a quick tour round his crib.
The oldest ceiling in England.
Gosh.
The oldest complete ceiling in England. Built in about 11:30. Not AM, 11:30.
Yeah, I was going to say before lunch.
It's older than Westminster Abbey. It's over 1,000 years old.
Believable.
And it turns out the BG has been following Pete's progress around town, and he's proper impressed.
But the carnival has been a very important part of Tame, and you're right, it does need recharging. Hey. It's a great thing you're doing. It's a heavy undertaking you're doing, and I admire you for it. And everybody in Tame appreciates you for taking this on.
But what's Robin got that's suitable for the raffle?
Oh, here's the boss.
PJ, here's my donation. Oh. I hope it's some use. Me and John Travolta.
Wow. Amazing.
Congratulations, Tame Carnival 2011. Love Robin Gibb, Bee Gees. A smiley face. And a kiss.
Thank you, Robin. Thank you to your family. And you've made a big difference to the Tame Carnival now. You really have.
With only hours to go to Carnival in the morning, Team Andre turn their attention back to their own float. And it seems like they may have taken their eye off the ball.
And what's the plan for dressing the actual float?
Well, it's a good question, actually.
We're getting the band...
you know, the drummers
and all that. We're getting that on our float.
It needs to be, the floor needs to be dressed in something. It's 44 foot long, we need to fill it.
Yeah, we will.
Oh, I don't know, mate, it's massive, dude. We're all gonna be in disguise. They might not know it's us on the float.
Coming up, the big day dawns, but the weather takes a turn for the worse.
I can't believe the weather! What have you done to us?
Will Team Andre make it to the parade on time?
Wow! What the hell's going on, man? This is half done.
And will the crowds they hope for turn up?
Can you hear me?
Peter Andre is in Tame in Oxfordshire, helping hairdressers Mark and Jade put a small-town carnival back on the map. So far, he's managed to blag a lorry, dancers and costumes to put on a Team Andre float. And he's persuaded local shops and celebs to donate raffle prizes to raise money for local charities. Now, Pete just has to hope that everyone turns up and that Team Andre put on a show to remember on their own float. Easier said than done.
All he's done since he's got here is whinge, whinge, right. Whinge.
It's Saturday and 11 a.m. in the centre of Tame, Carnival Day. The procession is due to start in just under an hour.
Can you hear me?
Yeah!
But the streets are hardly rammed. Despite the empty pavements, Mark has another concern.
A bit nervous. I don't know what's going on. I just want the clouds to stop pouring down rain.
What happened to the weather?
But a couple of minutes later, the heavens open and it looks like the day could be a total washout.
I can't believe the weather. What have you done to us? God. Everyone else has helped us, we need your help.
And there's another problem. The Team Andre float is still just a bare, empty lorry.
Thank you. Thank you. Just please.
Carl! What the hell's going on, man? This is half done.
Because they've been so busy, the team have forgotten to decorate it.
Come, right, that's it. I'm getting up here now. We've got to sort this out, Carl. Serious.
Do you know what? All he's done since he's got here is whinge, whinge,
right.
Whinge.
Have we got a shovel?
Eyeing up a nearby float, Pete comes up with a quick fix.
Excuse me. You got any more balloons, sir? Please, please. Well, tell me you're a champion.
Do you want a load of ribbon?
You know what? Can I actually give you a hug? Because you're helping me out big time.
Tell you what, I'm having a bit of that.
Come on, give me a cuddle. Mate, you are a champ of champs. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that. Right, I've got to get to work. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Let's go, guys. Leave it in 25 minutes.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started.
With minutes to go, the decorations for the float are sorted. But there's still a problem. There's no sign of the samba band Pete did a deal with to perform on the float.
We've got 5 minutes to get changed.
OK, you've got 2 minutes before it starts to leave at the other end.
It's 12 o'clock, and even though Pete's float isn't ready, the front of the procession heads off. Luckily, Team Andre are bringing up the rear, so have a few more minutes before they have to leave. And even though they can't yet see it, there is some good news. In the centre of Tame, a large crowd is gathering. And with seconds to spare, the samba band turn up, which means Team Andre's float is ready to rock and roll.
Yeah, so far so good. We've literally just come up the road and we're now, I think, literally just being held to carry on the procession. But yeah, already you can see we're all overly excited.
The float begins its journey into the town centre and the boys still haven't seen the crowds.
Lots of people in the streets.
But as they turn into the high street, the sun is out and the turnout is bigger and better than anyone could have expected. By the time the crowd see the Team Andre float, they are well and truly buzzing.
Mr. Peter Andre!
I think there's about 6,000, 7,000 people. It's incredible. Someone
someone said 10,000, but I'm like, oh my God, man. This is the best, this is just the best feeling in the world.
Guys, we did it!
We did it! Place once and for all and show them that Tame Carnival is back on track.
When the procession reaches the fete which the committee has organised, the party starts all over again.
This is what the Tame Carnival should be like every year. You guys are incredible, let me tell you.
But Pete isn't quite finished yet. He's got one final party trick up his sleeve.
We're running a tug-of-war competition, and let me tell you, whoever wins the tug-of-war is going to have to compete against Team Andre, because we're going to go tug-of-war with you.
If you
everybody.
Seems like the whole of Tame is here, the whole borough is here. But you know what? What a success.
Pete hosts the raffle with all the prizes and donations the team have collected. With the huge crowd present, it looks like they might have raised some serious dosh this year.
I am here to announce the winner of the raffles now. We have a signed photo of the legend Robin Gibb with John Travolta. It's Bryony.
The team have done it. It's clear this year's carnival is a roaring success. Pete exceeded his target of 20 floats, which are up from 2 last year to 24, a new record. The crowd figures are also up, from the miserable 800 of last year to a staggering 10,000 people. And the raffle has so far raised over £5,000 for local charities. Everyone's delighted.
The atmosphere's been amazing. The amount of people, the crowd. This is a real carnival.
I really hope they carry this on and it can galvanise the community and that these guys can all do this again next year, because it's been a really, really fun day.
With the carnival drawing to a close, it's time for Pete and the team to say goodbye.
Mark and Jade here, they're the ones that sent in the video for us to help with the carnival this year, for Here to Help. So it's thanks to these guys, and I hope you guys are proud.
I just want to say a big thank you on behalf of the whole of Tame and Tame Committee to Peter Andre and the whole of the Andre team.
We have been so welcomed here in the last 3-4 days. It's one of the nicest towns, honestly, that we've been to. We were saying we filmed a lot of Here to Help and they've been great, but this was a community one and you lot are amazing. So thank you.
Carnival's been an absolutely huge success. I'm overwhelmed of how many people have turned up for the event. We've got all the community back together again, which we wanted. We've raised a lot of money for charity. I'm totally exhausted, but you know what? I can't wait for next year.
Thank you. Good night or good afternoon.
We saw a town rock today, and that was something we haven't had a challenge of before, and I loved every minute of it. You know,
I wish you'd worn a grass skirt now, though. So it's getting nearer. Where you've got the X Factor coming back, you've got the Extra Factor along with it. And that kicks off this Saturday at 9:15 on ITV2. Stay there, though. Daniel Craig is coming to your rescue next in Casino Royale.